Have you ever wondered where to find assets to images like this one? In this video, I will show you the workflow of using Megascans with 3ds Max. For those of you who have never heard about Megascans, it is a website with thousands of scans, 3D and 2D assets. Thanks to this technique, the quality is really impressive, and it is a great choice if you want to create photorealistic visualizations. At the time I'm recording this video, there are new Megascans trees in their library. Anyway, if we scroll down, we can click on the first image, which redirects us to Megascans library. This way, we'll land in the Quixel Megascans browser, where we can find all the 3D models and 2D assets. We can find here, for example, materials, 3D models of architectural elements, 3D plants, all collections, and so on. If we choose the collections from the left-hand side panel, we can find different categories there. I like to look for assets this way, as I can easily find all things I may be interested in one place. Each category has subcategories, so it narrows our search even more. Okay, as you have a good understanding of what you can get from Megascans, I like to show you the workflow of using these assets. First of all, you need to have the Quixel Bridge installed from their website. So you can see the same assets here as on the website. If you go to purchase, you will see all the models you have bought and you can download them from here. If you click on the avatar icon, here you can see how many points you have left to purchase the assets. Also, the Quixel Bridge is smart and there is no possibility that you pay for one asset twice. You will have this green icon download here visible if you own the model. If you go to purchased category, you will have a blue icon if you have the model downloaded, so you just need to export it to the software. But it's not an issue if you purchase the model and don't download it straight away. You will have this model in your library. What is pretty cool about this, you can preview the assets in 3D and check them from different sites. You just need to click on the model and choose this preview option. Cool, isn't it? It is pretty handy as it guarantees that the purchase will be good. Now let me show you how to export the model to the software. Choose the asset you have bought earlier, click Settings at the bottom of the bridge, and choose Export Settings. Here, you can choose the software you will use. For me, it will be 3ds Max. The important thing is that you need to have the plugin installed for the software you will choose. If it's installed, you will get information here. Here, you can choose what format of the textures you need. I will leave JPEG. And here, you can choose the maps you want to get with the material. In the Models tab, you can choose the quality of the models. If you want to get the high-res poly model, you should have this option checked. As you set everything as you want, click Back and then click Export. And now, the magic happens. The file with the exported assets will be automatically opened. It will have the ready material applied as well. All the maps will be automatically saved in the Megascans library folder in the documents. It will create the material based on the render engine you have chosen in your render settings. Let me show you how easy the process is when working on a specific scene. I've used the scene from our advanced exterior training as an example. In case you want to check it out, I put a link in the corner. I will go back to the Quixel Bridge and choose this mossy tree branch to use in the scene. I click Export. And here we go, we have the model in the scene. With the use of the Select and Place option, we can position our model. You can also use the Y shortcut on your keyboard. I will scale the object and place it somewhere immersed in the water. Now let me show you how we can edit the material to achieve the effect of the wet parts of the branch in the water. We can unplug the base color for the moment and set the black color to see the results better. Start interactive rendering. Let's create the effect of the wet material in the needed places. We can use the corona distance map and plug it into the base roughness slot. I will choose water as an object, from which the map will take the distance. I will copy the black color as a color insight. And now, I will try to set the distance far value. I will start with 10 cm. So you can notice that the parts that have black color in roughness will be fully reflective, and the parts that have white color in roughness won't be reflective. Now let's plug the roughness map into the far color slot. I will increase the distance near to 3 cm, so the parts 3 cm from the water will be more reflective. And I will increase the distance far value now. Add the mix map and use the color distance map as a mask, so we will adjust the base color maps. Plug the map into the Color 2 slot and create a darker and more contrasty version of the texture and plug it into the Color 1 slot. Here we go! The material is done. I will also show you the workflow of importing their materials to 3ds Max. Let's take this one as an example. Similarly, as with 3D assets, we can preview the surfaces here. We don't have to change any settings, we can just go straight to exporting. And you can see that we have the material automatically uploaded to the material editor. Cool, isn't it? We can add this material to the water object and start interactive rendering to see the results. Okay, first of all, we need to change the mode to roughness as it doesn't work correctly because we have a roughness map. As you remember, the glossiness and roughness work opposite. But we need to turn on refractions as well. I will use the roughness texture to create a map from refractions. I will use color correction though to invert colors. Nice! We can decrease the refraction amount as it's too transparent now. Also, I will add a bit of absorption color to the water. And maybe now, let's make the water a bit more transparent. Let's wait a bit to see the final result. Great! I like this effect. Now, the workflow I've just shown you is a part of lessons from our advanced exterior training. If you would like to learn more cool things like this, based on 4 different visualizations, I'd like to invite you to join our course. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!